volcanoes. They exist with a theoretical potential to erupt again in 79 of the world's 195 countries. And since volcanic eruptions of any kind come along with their hazards, sadly, in 38 of these countries, their eruptions have caused fatalities. Yet, each deadly event in a particular nation provides an excellent case study for a scientist or a government to learn from to prevent future volcanic eruption-related deaths. Thus, today's video will discuss each of the deadliest volcanic eruptions by country which caused at least one fatality. Some of the nations included in this list are Canada, Peru, North Korea, and even Azerbaijan. Yet, there are also some nations that, despite containing more than a dozen active volcanoes, have so far never been the site of a proven deadly volcanic eruption. Standout examples of such include Argentina, which has 31 active or potentially active volcanoes, and Kenya, which has 19 such volcanoes, yet no volcanic eruption-related deaths. With that out of the way, let's get started. At the bottom of this list, we have Spain, where, during 1677, its Cumbre Vieja volcano erupted in a moderately explosive manner, creating toxic gas emissions which killed a man and many nearby animals. In 640, a moderately explosive Strombolian-style eruption within Saudi Arabia's Harat Uwairid volcanic field ejected lava bombs which killed several herders in the vicinity, although the exact death toll isn't truly known. In Nicaragua, the 1835 Plinian eruption of the Cosaguina volcano caused 5 fatalities from collapsing roofs due to heavy ashfall. In Yemen, a 2007 explosive eruption near a military base comprising a volcanic island known as Jabhat al-Tayr resulted in 7 fatalities. In 1778, the Rykoki volcano in Russia produced a major explosive eruption, hurling lava bombs which killed 15 of a ship's crew. 15 fatalities also occurred during the eruption of Tanzania's Kayeho volcano in 1800 via lava flows, and without specifics from Ethiopia's Aleto volcano in 1907. The 1903 pre-eruption phase of the Karthala volcano in Comoros killed 17 due to toxic gas release, while in 1995, a lateral blast from the United Kingdom's Soufriere Hills volcano on the island of Montserrat killed 19. Next on our list, we have an entry that is a bit uncertain. Straddling the border of Azerbaijan and Armenia is the Porak volcano, which erupted in 778 BCE at the same time as a very close-by battle. Many casualties, which I am guessing are more than 20, were reported by historical accounts claiming that a village was destroyed by the eruption, but for all we know, these could have been casualties caused by the battle or its aftermath. In Tonga, the 1853 eruption of Niuafoʻou opened a fissure directly in the middle of a populated village, erupting lava flows which killed 25. The 1948 eruption of Villarrica in Chile created destructive lahars which killed 54. In 1968, a major explosive eruption of the famed Arenal volcano in Costa Rica, perhaps even associated with a lateral blast, sent pyroclastic flows downslope to its west which killed 87. In 1870, major lahars from the Ambae volcano in Vanuatu headed towards the southeast, causing 100 fatalities. The 1861 eruption of Dubi in Eritrea killed 106 via lengthy pyroclastic flows, with pyroclastic flows causing 153 fatalities during the much larger 1886 explosive eruption of Okatania in New Zealand, with many fatalities there occurring at a series of travertine terraces popular with tourists and locals alike. During the 1630 Plinian eruption of the Furnace volcano in Portugal's Azores island chain, 195 fatalities occurred due to pyroclastic flows and collapsing roofs from heavy ashfall. In the Democratic Republic of the Congo, 250 fatalities occurred when during the 2002 eruption of the Nyiragongo volcano, incredibly fast-moving lava flows in some spots exceeding 40 miles per hour raced down the volcano's southern flank. The deadliest eruption in the United States occurred in 1790 when a major phreatomagmatic eruption of Hawaii's Kilauea volcano at its summit created pyroclastic surges that killed 400. North Korea's caldera-forming eruption of Paektu in 946, known as the Millennium Eruption, likely killed over 1,000 in my opinion. However, there are for some reason no confirmed reports of any deaths, but I don't buy that part based on the sheer size of the eruption in question and presumed regional population at the time. In the Solomon Islands during the year 1568, almost the entire population of Savo Island was killed, with 1,007 fatalities during an explosive eruption of the volcano that comprises said island. Pyroclastic flows during a major explosive eruption of the La Soufre volcano in St. Vincent in the Grenadines killed 1,352 in 1902, while in 1600 Peru's Huayna-Putina volcano produced an ultra-planean eruption, causing 1,500 fatalities via lengthy and large lahars. An explosive eruption with pyroclastic flows turned into a major landslide which killed 1,900 during the 1840 eruption of Turkey's Mount Ararat. Mexico's El Chichon killed 2,000 due to extensive pyroclastic flows during its 1982 eruption, while in 1700 the same number of fatalities occurred due to toxic gas emissions pooling at a low point where three villages were located in Canada due to advancing lava flows from the eruption of the Siax Cone. In 1951, Papua New Guinea's Lamington volcano produced a lateral blast that killed 2,942, while in the same year, the Himok-Himok volcano in the Philippines may have killed as many as 3,000 from pyroclastic flows. In 1902, the Santa Maria volcano produced a major eruption, killing 4,455 due to a combination of pyroclastic flows and heavy ashfall collapsing structures. Ecuador's Tungurahua erupted in 1640, causing 5,000 fatalities presumably due to generated pyroclastic flows. The Laki eruption of Iceland's Grímsson volcano in 1783 killed 9,350 via famine, which originated from mass livestock deaths that specifically were triggered from fluorine poisoning due to abundant fluorine-rich fallen volcanic ash. A landslide-generated tsunami at the Unzen volcano during eruption in Japan during 1792 killed 15,135, while the 79 CE eruption of Vesuvius in Italy killed 16,000 via pyroclastic flows and ashfall collapsing buildings. Colombia's Nevado del Ruiz erupted in 1985 into a thick glacier, generating the world's deadliest lahar on record, which killed 25,000, most of which were nearly 30 miles from the eruption site. A lateral blast on France's island of Martinique in the Caribbean in 1902 at the Pelee volcano killed 29,803. In Greece, during 1610 BCE, a caldera-forming eruption killed 30,000 via primarily pyroclastic flows at the Santorini volcano, while a combination of pyroclastic flows, thrown lava bombs, heavy ashfall collapsing buildings, tsunamis, and famine during the eruption aftermath killed 61,000 during Tambora's 1815 eruption. And the deadliest eruption in human history occurred due to the ultra-planean eruption of Ilopango in El Salvador in the year 431, causing as many as 100,000 fatalities due to thick ashfall, extensive pyroclastic flows, and possible famine in the eruption's aftermath. And now, a brief review of the stated data. Thanks for watching.